Hello, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and here comes another episode of Hearts of Iron 4 Base Game with Germany. So you may have noticed that we already have gotten America under our grasp with it, but... And let's just say that, well... Ooh, let's see. I can hire a new operative. Awesome. Let's see. Oh, maybe I'll hire an operative from Papua New Guinea. Oh, and guess what? Before I started recording, our boy Chiang Kai-shek now truly finally rules China once again. Yep, Chiang Kai-shek takes the nationalist leadership of China, and I don't want anyone ruining it. They may have averted our civil war. They may have averted a civil war. It's funny how China's also at war. China and its puppets are also at war with Japan and stuff. Too bad they can't get through via Korea to Japan, because that's just wasting materials. But they can be able to get through this way. Also, why... I don't get it, but why is Japan still annexing this area of territory? Oh wait, never mind. Krakow. Alright. I'm not here to help you, Japan. I just want the war to end so I can have a favorable position. Then I'll help America beat Japan's butt. With China in it, because... I'm getting bored. Might as well just help America for all I care. Aw, man. Oh wait, the Sea Battle of Hamilton. Wow. Admiral Arleigh Burke. Let's see here. An anti-Soviet pact. That'll be a good one. I may not be able to get to South Africa in this part of Britain, but hey, whichever works. Who dares win? I mean, I don't even have, like, Army Landsheet on, and this is not even fair. Like, oh my god, no. Appalachia. Yeah, that's how it's spelled. Appalachia. I'm already entering New England. Well, Mr. Roly-Poly Roosevelt, time to meet your doomed. Although, I wouldn't say actual doom, more like, you know. What's this? Mexican Socialist State has war goals against Catholic Mexico. Really? Catholic Mexico is still at a civil war with the Mexican Socialist Republic? How does that even make any sense? You know what, I'm not even gonna bother ask anyway. Like, who would even care? As long as Chiang Kai-shek rules China, I'm A-okay with it. Too bad the Soviet Union can't get me from here. The best they can do is just try to declare war on Altai, for all I care. Let's see here. Maybe I'll just can't. Okay, Turkey delivers an investment portfolio. Representatives from Turkey have visited our country and met with many of our politicians in hope of gathering endorsements for their investment scheme. The government of Turkey would like for us to use our resources to better their own industrial capabilities and output. Turkish officials have inferred that by assisting their nation, we might be able to expect aid of our own in the future in the form of military alliance between our nations. If it's aid they want, then it's aid they shall have. There we go. And Denmark is just there, all alone. It's funny because I already occupied Denmark. And the US didn't even bother take... Oh lord. This is too much. Soviet operative captured already? How many operatives am I even capturing at this point? Oh yeah, I almost forgot. I forgot I had that focus tree change. I kind of forgot about that, but that'll be removed from the next episode, or basically seeing that this is the final episode. Yeah, parliamentary. Let's see. Paramilitary train. Let's do all the basic paramilitary training. I am not going to do resource exploitation. I'm not touching that. Jesus Christ. Is a lot of America's troops still solely... the fall of New York. After... After hours of street warfare, much of it reportedly against armed irregulars, German spearheads have advanced into New York City and taken control of the city. Improvised anti-tank barriers placed along Fifth Avenue proved ineffective, and panzer grenadiers fought their way through Manhattan block by block. Fires have been raging out of control in the eastern parts of the city for several days, lighting up the skylight at night. The Statue of Liberty was decapitated by a stray artillery round, though which side fired it remains a matter of dispute. Another victory for the Vaterland. Sorry about the change of the tabs. I didn't realize what I was clicking on. Ah, finally a British operative. Sweet. I am not blowing up the Suez Canal. That's just gonna make it worse. I already took over the entire eastern seaboard. What's this? A port strike? And I lost 25 aircrafts compared to 9 damaged early destroyer hulls. Wow. Ah, rescue captured operative. Alright, now I have to focus back on California, where the government has just exiled itself from Washington, D.C. to Los Angeles. Let's just hope that... Oh boy. This is just so fun. I'm already almost close up to the US-Canadian border up here. Once after the peace treaty is concluded, I'll make sure these armies get back to their rightful places in Africa. Erwin Rommel's paratrooper division. That reminds me, I could also change up the railways. Give US more railways, because why not? Let's see now. Alright, finally our operative is now back on track. Wow, that's a lot of railways. Oh, the railways. railway from... Ah, yes, the railway heading from Atlanta, Georgia, to the United States. Yep. Yep, the train. Yep, there goes the trains heading out. Whoa! Vichy French and American ships are fighting each other? Oh wait, no, Vichy French submarines fighting battleships. Oh my god, man. This is too much. Let's see. Damage taken by friendly divisions. Oh, amount of planes carrying out. Oh, 54 planes and 25% shot. Wow. Our modern 1985 aircraft really are doing the work. There we go, more aircrafts to research. The better the payload. Yes, all these railways are going fine. We shall build more to help the US railway industry from its sluggish economy. Finally! Oh boy, a 1980s interceptor. How nice. Okay, let's just say I don't really need those aircraft anymore. There we go. Dang, all of... All of the major U.S. coast is just taken like a piece of cake. It's not even funny. Really? Catholic Mexico recalls attache. We shall recall our Catholic Mexico attache. Our attaches will be sent where they please. Besides China, I'm supporting your war against the Japanese. I'm not doing this the other way around. Mm-hmm. Oh, finally, now I can hire one. I can hire now a Canadian operative? Okay. Huh. Nice. I don't want my puppets in this war. I'm basically doing all the hard work myself. There we go. The Junkers. Oh dang, New England has just been cut in half. Yep. Intel network strength and local nationality, 30%. What's even more good is that Mackenzie King is now leading an independent UK. I mean, independent Canada. Sorry if I kind of butchered that. Alliance with Spain. Operation Tannenbaum. Ah yes, let them bleed each other dry. Time to research rocketry. Rocket propulsion holds the key to a massive innovation in all three of the military branches. I think it's time for me to slowly start replacing some of my old aircrafts with the new ones. So let's see if I can do this. Mm-hmm. The 1980 Interceptor, hold on. Counterintelligence is serious. Whoa, China, you took over Manchuria already? Dang, that was actually quick. I'm actually kind of surprised. Also, I was wondering how China is going to get rid of this border gore of Japan occupying Mongolia and the Mongol Autonomous Government also occupying it. Like, this border gore is just so disgusting. It's funny how I'm at war with Tanatuva, Sinkang, and the Soviet Union, but I'm divided by them thanks to Kazakhstan and Altai. So, yeah, they don't even stand a chance. Not that I care or anything. Ah, yes, our first steps into Canada. Carrier CAS of 1980, aka CAS meaning close air support. The cipher for the Soviet Union has now been fully decrypted. Hooray! Finally! I was wondering when it was going to be. Yeah, for the heck of it, for the heck of it, I'll just help build more railways anyway. Finally. Air Transport 1990. I'm having so many promoted air pilots. It's like, what is this? Air pilot promotion day? Like, come on, I'm having so many of these. Ah, yes. State, the capital, Washington, D.C. It's very hot, but it's also raining. A dark, gloomy day for D.C. indeed. Finally, the alright, I know I keep getting all these. Oh lord, I'm not even gonna bother ask. Oh, okay, now the US is already. Okay, now the German forces are already infiltrating Texas. Oh boy. To one of my friends seeing this video who's from Texas, I am very sorry in advance for this, but it's an alternate history video, don't get upset. It's funny, I can't offer them peace yet. You are not the war leader of the losing side. No, Italy, I'm not getting you or my puppets in this. I don't want you in this war. All right, finally. Just a few more aircrafts to research, and then I'll finally get rid of my old aircrafts. But before I plan on doing that, oh, Blazkowicz is wounded now? How unfortunate. Also, I was gonna say, did any territorial change just happen a while ago? Oh. Oh, seems like Zambia was set free. Huh. I didn't expect that to happen. And Free France still retains over Madagascar. That is so hilarious. Okay, here we go. Ah, the TA. Let's increase the range of this aircraft with powerful engine weapons. Yeah, I know this is gonna take a long time, but hey, when it comes to upgrading your aircraft to create a variant, I love this part very much. Alright, finally, at least a Finally, now I can be able to actually add more engine and range. Okay, let's do some better range for this aircraft. 12,250. Let's see, close cast support, 1980. Yeah, no, I'm just coming up with random names. Deal with it. Yeah, I know I'm clicking a lot, but hey, that's the best I could do, like, take it or leave it. You know? It's like they say. Time to do the great replacement of my old aircrafts. Alright, let's see what other aircrafts I might have to replace. Nah, I think that's it for the most part. Strange, why can't I be able to move? Okay, this is weird. Why can't I move a... Oh yeah, I forgot. I could technically move a... Oh yeah, I forgot. I can actually move a map using this. Aw, man. Now we're getting pushed back like crazy. Oh wait, but I'm pushing the so... Both of my units are pushing them to the Mexican Socialist Republic? Huh. I don't know how I even feel about that, but okay. We're gonna give Turkey every single investment if they need it. Yep, it's basically a battle for the eastern coast of the United States. I know this war is taking forever, but you gotta understand, it's already still 1943, so like, don't cry about it. Oh no. Socialist Republic of Bulgaria mining concessions? What is this? Oh no, 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 no. A communist country that's part of my faction. You gotta be kidding me, what happened? Total War, Third Bulgarian Empire? I guess maybe I do have one more thing to do on my list before I start going nuts. You know what, to heck with it. I'll just kick them out of the faction, declare, justify war, and all that stuff. I do not even want them as a member of my border. hate when I need to get more political power. There. There we go. There we go. I have my. I'm not going to make Bulgaria cause more trouble than it is. And it's a good thing they joined the Socialist Comintern pack and not the Allies, because that would have been a way too much far heat closer to home. Meanwhile, back in the eastern US, Jesus, things are really going crazy. But I have more backup on the way, so that'll be good. And even a lot more of my allies are also helping. Even Romania, too! Even though we're just sending their troops there only just to... Finally! There we go. Bulgaria is done for. So, partition Bulgaria with Bulgaria, and that'll be my focus. The war ends, thank God. Alright, finally. Bulgaria has already fallen so low. Well, I mean, at least the US eastern coast is already holding good, so that's progress. Zambia got its freedom, so I'm not even gonna bother with that. Oh dang, the Japanese already did a landing in the same area where they would have done back in... Sheesh. And I'm basically the one helping them with giving them Lend-Lease and all that stuff. Head to the city of Varna. I want all of Bulgaria. Alright, finally. Next focus. Wunderwaffe. Heisenberg and von Braun are chomping at the bite to explore certain ideas they have been for true doomsday weapons. All they need is extra resources. Alright, finally. The fate of Bulgaria. What should we do? Satellite Bulgaria as it is. Direct control. Actually, we do satellite Bulgaria as it is. Legionary Bulgaria Yep. Yeah, satellite Bulgaria as it is with the land they got. Finally, so we got that squared away. Now I can focus back in Europe. I mean, North America. Ah, you know what? I'm getting too tired of this. Yeah, I'm gonna put the speed up the army thing. I'm only doing it just for a little. I'm not gonna do it like to the point where like the nations are gonna surrender. So yeah. Yeah, this might take a bit long, but yeah, who cares? And it's good to help out Catholic Mexico, too. You know what? Screw this. I want this to be the last episode or whatnot. I mean, I want this 11th episode to be the last episode, or the 12th episode to be the last one, but I really don't care by this point. Well, it seems like Australia is now leader of the Alliance. Maybe I can do an automatic white piece. Hang on, let me do something for 1 minute. Okay, now let's accept. Let's accept the peace offer. Wow, I have to say that the world map actually looks very different now. I guess you can say that I decided to occupy much of the old and the Western world under German rule. You know what? I think this is a good time where I'll just stop at this episode, and this is actually it for the series. So I hope you lads and lassies liked the 11 episodes so far. And I'll see you guys next time when I start up a new one. Thank you, and have a great day. And also, by the way, none of this is meant to be taken literally. This is literally a game. That's why it's called Hearts of Iron 4, and also because you just make what you want in your own fantasy world. This is fantasy, not reality, so I'm just letting y'all know for now. Anything I do is purely not based on political or whatever mumbo jumbo you guys think in your own small town world. I think of this more as a gameplay just to know how countries operate and how they would felt in their own world if they did succeed in those plans. Sort of like a what if, but like in the realm of fantasy. So don't take this literally, and I'll see you guys next time.